can share in this meeting bartha ide. Unit of Sanatana at Mysore in association with the Rotary Club of Mysore West. Prayer is the process of talking to God in order to achieve a purpose. So let us begin this webinar by seeking the blessing of Lord Almighty. Vakratunda Mahakaya Koti Surya Samaprabha Nirvignam Kurume Deva Sarva Karyeshu Sarvada. Now I request Professor Shashank S. to welcome and introduce the speaker of today's webinar. I also request him to welcome the guest and participants. Over to Professor Shashank.
A very good morning to one and all. I take this opportunity on behalf of Sanatana Research and Training Institute, Mysore, to welcome today's speaker, Dr. P. Rishankara, Associate Professor, Manakala Vinayagar Institute of Technology, Pondicherry, official from Rotary Club of Mysore, participant from different parts of the country. Dr. P. Shivashankaran has obtained his B.A. degree in Mechanical Engineering from Pallavan College of Engineering, Kanjipuram, and M.A. in Industrial Engineering from Tyagarajagar College of Engineering, Madurai. He has obtained his Ph.D. in Industrial Engineering from Anna University in the year 2015. He is having a total of 10 years of teaching experience in various cadres, and currently he is working as an Associate Professor at Manakula Vinayagar Institute of Technology, Pondicherry. He has published total 35 papers in reputed international and national journals, and also presented many papers in international conferences. He has published books on quality management, process planning and cost estimation, managerial economics and computer integrated manufacturing, automation for excellence. He has organized 15 workshops and guest lectures on recent technological advances in the area of industrial engineering. He is a peer reviewer and editorial board member of various reputed international journals. He is a life member of Indian Institute of Industrial Engineering, Mumbai, IIE in the USA, and Teaching and Education Research Association, Eurasia Research. He is a proficient in software such as design for assembly, AutoCAD, RoboDoc, etc. He has guided various academic projects of UG and PG students. He is regularly applying for projects, seminars, grants, FDPs, HTPs under various schemes of DSC, CSIR, NSNTM, and AICT. He has carried out a novelty research on the work titled Comparison of Jute and Steel Fiber Reinforced Composite Using Thrust PCB with the support of C Intel Services, Chennai. He has actively participated in various FDPs, national and international workshops, FDPs at various institutions. He has delivered guest lectures at the institutional level and also at reputed industries on the topics related to software application and other industrial engineering areas. The beautiful thing about learning is that nobody can take it away from you. So never stop learning. When you stop learning, then you stop growing. Learning gives creativity. Creativity leads to thinking. Thinking provides knowledge, and knowledge makes you great. Knowledge is divine, knowledge is powerful, and it should be shared. An industrial robot is a robot system used for manufacturing. Typical applications of robot include welding, painting, assembly, disassembly, pick and place for printed circuit boards, packaging and labeling, palletizing, product inspection and testing, all accomplished with high endurance, speed and precision. Material handling makes use of the robot's simple capability to transport objects. By fitting the robot with an appropriate end of arm tool, the robot can efficiently and accurately move product from one location to another. Material handling applications include material transfer and machine loading and unloading. Material transfer application requires the robot to move the material for both parts from one location to another. Machine loading and unloading operation utilize a robot to load and unload the parts at a production machine. So today's national webinar on material handling system in robotics. With this, I wish all the participants will have a fruitful interaction with the speaker. Once again, thank you one and all.
Thank you, sir. Now I request Dr. P. Shivashankaran, Associate Professor, Manakula Vinayagar Institute of Technology, Pondicherry, to start his session. Over to sir. To sir.
Thank you. A very good morning to one and all present here. So let me introduce about myself. I am Dr. P. Sivashankara, currently working as Associate Professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Manakula Vinayagar Institute of Technology, Pondicherry. So as per the schedule, the session number 2, today we are going to discuss about the material handling systems in robotics. In session 1, so we saw about the basic fundamentals of industrial robotics. So about what are the different configurations of a robotic system. Let us say polar coordinate, Cartesian coordinate system, scalar robots. So these are the different basics, fundamentals we have discussed in the session 1. So now with reference to the application, so we are going to see what are the various types of material handling robots that are used in the factory operation. Along with some case studies, we are going to discuss how material handling systems are done in a more comfortable way in spite of using a human operator in a more hazardous place. So this is my proposed agenda for today's workshop. So first, let us understand what is the importance of material handling, an overview of that. Then later we will move on to the use of robotics in material handling system and what are the general consideration to select a robot for a material handling with respect to design consideration. Then what are the different types of material handling robots that are used widely in industries. And we are going to see 2 case studies in material handling system using robotics application. The first case study, automatic assembly of a car tire into the axle, car axle, using machine vision system. The next, second case study is about automation of a CNC machining center using a 7-axis pick and place robotic arm assembly. So along with the case study, finally, we are going to conclude how important the material handling robots plays a major role in day-to-day the factory operation. Before going to the session, so let us understand the objective of today's session. So the major goal of the program in today's session, so we are going to see the material handling importance in the factory related task. So that we are going to see in the first few slides. Then in the later part of the slide, we are going to see some of the in different typical configurations of material handling robots that we are going to discuss. Then last one, application of material handling robots with a few case studies that are also we have to discuss. So based on the objective, the session outcome, so finally, you will be getting gaining some knowledge about the industrial robots and material handling system for doing various operations. And also we can able to select the specific mission, the material handling robot for particular application area. So this is going to be the outcome at the end of the presentation. Now we will move on to the importance of material handling. So an outlay, an initial overview. So material handling, as the coordinator describes about the nature and role of material handling. So it is nothing but physical transformation of material from source to destination. So from one end to another end, so we have to move the huge bulk amount of material. So the human operator is not much a fair option to equip the material handling operation, because we have to consider the body ergonomics of a human operator. So in that aspect, to bring the comfort to the human personnel, so the automated robotic machines can be equipped to handle the jobs very compact manner. And also we can able to improve the speed and fastness in transferring the jobs from one end to the other end. So the material handling is one of the key important role in robotics system. So it will do the most complicated, the tedious job of a human being in a systematic programmed way, that is repetitive way in the production line. So moreover, the material handling robots try to improve the efficiency of the production line. That is nothing but increasing the throughput, the job completion rate by thorough inspection of the finished component. So thereby we can able to assure the quality, the product quality, through using the material handling robot system. So followed by the further continuation. So the main use of robots in material handling system is to assure the three things, okay? So maximizing the job completion rate throughput, then finished job quality, so we can able to give assurance to the customer. So by adding quality with all latest technology to bring out the product with zero defects, and also we can able to handle flexible schedule at any time, and moreover continuous improvement, the consistency. So the continuous improvement we can bring in by minimizing the ergonomic hazards of the human workers. So this is about the general introduction about the material handling system in industrial robotics related to a factory operation. How robots are used for doing such a task, material handling application. So normally there are two different areas. One is transferring the material, the other one is loading the material and unloading the material. Okay, then if you take a material transfer application, normally mobile robot applications are preferred in order to successfully move the items from one place to another place, right? So how robots are used in material handling application, further continuation. So by equipping the material handling robots in the material handling operation, we can able to maximize the overall the productivity of an organization. At the same time, we can also able to reduce the plant layout. We can revise the plant layout such that we can have a reduced floor space. So within that minimum space, we can have minimum number of machines to do the operation very effectively. So higher standard, safety standards we can able to bring for the worker. So thereby lot of value addition activities can be done through automation principle. What are the next thing we are going to see about, what are the general consideration from the design analysis, from the design point of view in bringing the robot to the exact real time environment. So first thing, part positioning and orientation. So the part positioning is nothing but using a gripper. So that will be handling the part with the help of the gripper. So how to position the part depending on the alignment, different axis movement. So we have to plan. So without hitting or colliding the nearby obstacles. The next one, gripper design. So which type of gripper design, mechanical or vacuum type gripper or a pneumatic type gripper. So these are the different the choices that are available in order to simplify the gripper design for handling the part very easily, and also we can able to move it quickly within a minimum distance. And work volume, that is nothing but work cell. So the average space required for a robot to carry out the particular the work. So probably in the session 3, we are going to discuss about the work cell, design of robotic work cell. So that we will be discussing a lot of things in session number 3. So the weight capacity, that is a payload, the arm weight. So what is the payload capacity of the robot arm while lifting the material? And at the same time, what is the full body weight of the machine, right? The next thing, accuracy and repeatability. So if the same operation is about to carry out for more than 10 times, so what will be the accuracy and repeatability we have to maintain? And using different robot configuration for the specific application area. So for example, simple linear part movement, we can use a Cartesian coordinate robot system. Or if it is a complicated movement like different wide range of angle we want to turn the robot arm, then we can use a polar coordinate system. So according to the different configuration based on the suitability of the application area, So we can able to select the different type of mission. So these are the general considerations. Now coming to the application of material handling robot. So you see the part transfer, the first one. So the type of robot, what you are seeing in the slide is a linear Cartesian coordinate robotic system. So for a simple small distance movement, okay, so it can able to transfer the path with the less minimal the axis movement, right? So the path transfer is nothing but converting the manual operation which has been done by the human being in the recent past into a full automated mechanism. So this increases the repetition, the accuracy and precision compared to the human operator in a much better way. So best example for a part transfer, so we can equip an industrial robot, namely Kuka robot, which has 6 degrees of freedom with a minimum payload capacity of 60 kg. So these kind of robot will handle small and medium parts for transferring the material. So it works on the principle of end of arm tooling method and the vision system, mission vision technology. With the help of the sensor, it will try to identify the object which has to be moved from the source to destination. And accordingly, it will position the arm to pick the material from the particular end with the help of the force driving system, let us say pneumatic or hydraulic driving mechanism. So these types of models are used for part transferring application, which will do multiple operations in a single mission. So the next application is a packaging application. So next to part transfer. So here the packaging applications are more versatile or flexible compared to the previous one, the part transfer. So it reduces the labor cost by increasing return on investment by improving the productivity. So namely, we can say end of arm tooling method is one particular concept which is used for packaging process. So the example of such a packaging application, Motoman HP26. So this is a special the robot with the technical specifications are given here. So it is a 6-axis robot followed by a minimum payload capacity of 6 kg, that is arm lifting capacity, the payload, and horizontal reachability of the arm is said to be 1,915 millimeter, and the vertical reach of arm, which can move about y-axis up to 3,459 mm. So it can able to do a repeatability of 0.06 millimeter. The total weight of the machine is said to be 285 kg. So this can be mounted anywhere on the floor, on the wall, ceiling. At a particular height, we can able to operate. So it is a dynamic high-speed robot with a very much compact design. And also we can develop a special program for building collision avoidance. So the robots that are used for a packaging application, so if you take multiple robots that are involved in a packaging application, so the neighborhood robot should not hit or collide with each other. So it has to align on its own by detecting the obstacle present nearby. So it has a built-in sensor, a collision avoidance sensor will be incorporated into the mission unit, so such that it will prevent the accidents by avoiding the collision. In such a way, it will adjust the arm in order to position the correct path where the workpiece materials are kept. So the design, this proposed design will allow the robot arm to move very close to the exact point of the workpiece holding fixtures to improve the easy accessibility of the part. The next third operation is palletizing. So industrial palletizing. So it is a small material handling unit which will help to store the raw material one above the other in a sequential pattern. It's like a tray-like appearance. So palletizing is a wooden tray or a wooden plate-like appearance. So it will stock minimum quantity of the finished item or a basic raw material so in a orderly manner such that it will not allow any overfalling of material away from the pallet. This can be automated by using the industrial robot. Normally in food processing industries, automobile manufacturing, then shipping, logistics, right? So the type of robot used for palletizing is given here along with the basic specifications. So next one, machine loading and machine tending operation. So this machine loading and tending, normally we cannot able to done with the manpower, physical manpower. It is a very dangerous one and hazardous task. So that may lead to have severe injury. So in order to overcome such thing, we can do automation by feeding the part into the machine automatically by loading the machine, by loading the part into the machine. And then we can able to bring out the finished part at the end of every cycle of operation. So this automated loading and unloading, so can be done with the help of the robotic machine very easily. Fanuc is one such a controller, so which tries to reduce the fatigueness of the labor such as in such a way that we can able to provide a reprogram the facility, so for a fast and cost effective model changeovers from every part model. And also it is more safe to operate, right? So we can also do this kind of robot is also do, it can also able to do welding operation, not only manufacturing, machining, it can also do multiple varieties of job in different stations. So now the next segment, so we are going to see about different series of configuration of material handling robots. So Kawasaki robot is one of the supplier, the leading supplier of the industrial robot, which has been described here. So these are the different model, the different make of a robot that can be classified by series number, varying from R series to Z series. So we can classify the series number depending on the minimum to maximum payload capacity and the reachability arm distance, based on which so we can categorize the different series of the assembly robot. Now we are going to see certain sample of so small and medium application robot. So R series robot. So the minimum weight, the payload weight, arm weight, that may vary to 3 to 80 kg, right? So the maximum arm reachability to access the part, so that will go up to 620 mm. So what are all the applications the R series robots are normally used? It is used for simple the PCB assembly, huge automobile the parts assembly, then machine loading and unloading, then material removal, then checking the seal of the bottle cap, right? So these are the basic general purpose application. So the R series robots are used. Next one, B series. So it is used for spot welding application. So optimized spot welding application. So the arm weight of the robot varies from 100 kg. It may be more than 100 or 300 also. So that depends upon the complexity of the application, what you are going to equip. And the maximum reachability is up to 1634, the distance, horizontal movement of the arm to pick up the component from the ground line. Then along with the assembly, machine loading, other application, it can also do friction, spot joining, and also spot welding operation. So is that series robot are said to be heavy duty robot. So it can able to do variety of operation by turning the arm to various angle in different direction. So these kind of robots are used for spot welding and also simple material handling. It is a multi-purpose application. So the payload is up to 300 kg and the reachability distance 2501 mm. Okay, so these are the different series types so that are available in the market. So depending on the advanced application, or we can able to select the particular robot for doing the assigned the task, right? So now we are going to see practical case study. So how material handling systems are effectively used in robotic application. So first, the case study we are going to discuss about the automated the wheel assembly system using an industrial robot with a PLC controller. So let us start discussing the description about the problem. So in the earlier days, the current method of mounting the wheel in automobile industry is done by the manual operators, that is a human being. So that is one of the time consuming and also tiring job done by the human workers with a lot of body pain and over tiredness we can able to measure. So in order to safeguard the ergonomic constraint of a human operator, so it is advisable to use an automated the PLC system to reduce the human effort and also the energy and the productive time. And also we can able to save the money. So for that purpose, so they utilized an automated machine vision system in order to capture the moving object on the conveyor. So here, this is the scanned 2D image of the real, the virtual, the platform. Okay, this is the conveyor line. So the car body will be moving at a very fast speed over the conveyor. So the robot has to sense the moving object. It has to detect the moving object randomly in such a way that so the arm should be planned to pick the tire and it has to be mounted here very comfortably without making any mistakes during the assembly the process. So that is the challenging the case objective of the problem, the proposed case study. So for that, they require an intelligent agent-based robot system to be developed for doing such complicated tasks. So this is the system network design. So how we can able to plan the path motion, arm motion in different directions. Okay, so in this case study, they did X and Y axis movement only for mounting the tire into the car axle. So here they used a 7-axis robot with a sensor, infrared sensor, controller and the conveyor. So initially the infrared sensor will detect the position, the movement of the car going over the conveyor line. So accordingly, it will pick up the wheels in order to load it randomly into the station, right? So this is the image which has been given here. In figure one, you can see that the gripper is positioned very close to the work material, the tire element. So in the figure two, the gripper will be holding the tire in order to lift the object to do the assembly process. Right. So here the force is applied on the Z axis of the robotic arm. So with the help of the so-called system, a pneumatic system, in order to drive the different mechanical element of the robotic parts to perform the wheel loading process. So the outcome, the end results of this case study, so using visual surveying method and a force control strategy, so they done this work. So the experiments were successfully carried out for the wheel loading application. And they saved a huge amount of time and also the energy by using such a developed robotic system for automobile assembly unit. So this gives a great impact in the automobile industry. So, right? So in the same order, the next case study, optimization of the plant layout design using automation. For a CNC machine too. So here also, so we can able to see how the material handling systems can be automated without the help of the human, the programmer, the CNC programmer, right? So the component manufacturing company, they are in the need to purchase a new CNC machine too in order to process a variety of tasks, variety of parts. So they have to maximize the revenue by equipping a new robot from the supplier called Yashikawa Motoman. This is the leading supplier of the robotic automatic solutions. So they need a CNC machine at the same time to do the loading and unloading process. So they want an industrial robot to do this the mechanism. So what are the challenges? So they want to do all this operation within a small room, a small area, within a limited floor space area. So that is the constraint is maximum limit fitted within 21 square feet area. So this is the challenge of the problem, right? So they can also use a flexible mobile robot to store various material items from various mission tools, right? So the solution, what they have to do, the requirement to be fulfilled. So the 7-axis robot is installed in the shop floor. And this 7-axis robot will do the multiple tasks like the pallet storage, the pallet lifters, storing the item with on the pallet, and it can able to lift the pallet along with the stored item using the method called Endoform dual gripper method. So here in this case study, instead of using a single gripper, two grippers are attached in the single arm. So that one gripper will be positioned. It will be helpful to position, place the job into the chuck of the machine. The other gripper will be removing the finished part from the machine. So this is called as combining identical similar operation in a single machine, such that we can able to reduce the operation change over the time. Okay, so instead of using two robots, we can use one single robot by following multiple gripper in a single arm, right? So these are the outcomes that are given here. The solution meets the expected project outcome. So for both the machining center and the robot, the compact robot does the full entire job within the given the floor space requirements. Right. So now before completing the workshop, so the final conclusion of today's the session, first we started discussing about the objectives of the material handling and what are the outcome of the session, the material handling. Then we started discussing the overview, the importance of material handling system. And then we moved on to what are the basic consideration of material handling robot. Starting from the design and make, then the next thing, different types of application and the types of material handling robots, followed by real-time case study, solved case study. Then now I conclude that based on this basic input, the information, I conclude that the material handling robotic systems will play a multi-dimensional role in different plant operations within the industry. So that may be varying from refrigeration or air conditioning manufacturing industry or automobile industry or food processing industry. Okay, so the material handling robot improves the human difficulties in performing the various tasks. At last, it can able to maximize the speed as well as the fastness in improving the accuracy and precision by taking much care in safety and attention. Right. So this is what I finally conclude before ending the seminar. So I once again thank all the participants and the program coordinator for giving me the chance to share my view on material handling system, the session number 2 in basics of industrial robotics. So thank you one and all present here.
Thank you, sir, for your wonderful and informative session. Now the participants can ask their questions or you can interact with the speaker by unmuting yourself. You have this provision. So over to all the participants. This robotics is an emerging field, as all of us know. So if anyone would like to pursue higher studies or research in this area, what are the probable areas, sir?
In doing a PhD research in the particular area, automation, so I can say that in supply chain management system, we can use the machine vision control in delivering the goods, raw material on time from the supplier to the manufacturer. You no need to make a phone call and contact supplier every now and then. So you can attach a kind of an IoT in a smart tracking device in the vehicle, such that so the manufacturer can able to find out the status of the raw material, okay, without making a phone call to the supplier. So these are the emerging research area, the machine vision system in the area of material logistics. At the same time, the factory automation. So I have shown you the case studies. Even emotional intelligence in medical field, in careful attentiveness of the patient health. So these are the emerging areas of research where we can able to apply the robotic science and the knowledge on the future research. Even the classroom, automated the classroom, smart classrooms, smart attendance monitoring systems. So nowadays people are using manual monitoring methods for taking the class attendance, the students' attendance. So if you equip smart attendance, it will automatically keep all the students' data in its memory. So such that we can able to retrieve the data as soon as possible in order to find out the number of the people who have attended today's session. Even for educational setup also, we can bring this kind of a smart way of the core culture.
Thank you, sir. Any other questions? Participants can ask questions or interact with the resource person. So you have discussed something about the robots today, for example, Motoman 7-axis robot. So and some specific robots you have discussed, how exactly these are different from the conventional robots that you have seen?
Yes, sir. So the conventional robots will be doing only a repeated identical operation, let us say painting, okay, or assembly of screws and fasteners. So these robots are considered to be multitasking. So the factory robots, the Kuka robots and Motoman, these are multi-tasking machines. So it will do high-level job and also very low-level task. And we have to ensure the payload capacity, the lifting capacity of the arm. Okay, so if you are going for a multi-diversified application, then we want to maximize the payload, maximum payload capacity of the robotic arm. In such a way, we have to design the control system to drive the different parts, the linkages of the that are associated in the complete the robot system.
Thank you. Any more questions? We don't have questions, we'll proceed. Now I request Professor Shashank to summarize today's webinar.
Thank you, sir. So it was a very wonderful session. In today's session, we have discussed about what are the importance of the material handling, then what are the different material handling systems can be used in the robotic section, and what are the considerations to be followed, the general requirements should be followed for the material handling system, and the types of material handling robots which are active in the unique industry. And then we had the two case studies where with respect to the material handling. So with this, I feel the participants had a very fruitful session. Thank you, sir. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Professor Shashank. Now, let us come to the end of the program. Gratitude is the essence of humanity. I thank Dr. P. Sivashankaran, Associate Professor, Manakula Vinayagar Institute of Technology, Pondicherry, for accepting our request to be the resource person of today's webinar, and also for delivering a very informative session on material handling in robotics. Thank you very much, sir. I thank Dr. Ramchandra CG, the Managing Trustee, Sanatana Research and Training Institute, University of Sanatana Sampratisthana, Mysore, and officials from Rotary Club of Mysore West for their involvement in organizing this webinar. I also thanks to Lokesh CG, President, Dr. Raghavan Prasad, MD, Akshantra Jairasan, Shrimati Bhagya Gopal, the Board of Trustees, Sanatana Sampratisthana for their support extended in organizing this webinar. Finally, I thank all the participants for your support and active participation in this webinar. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.